Hey guys, David here. Going to start my new weekly Iowa Hawkeye football blog. Now that the team is 7-0, I figured I'd give it a shot and give my weekly opinions before and after the game. And if you guys want to watch it, awesome. Let me know. Give me some comments. Let me know what you think. This week, Iowa travels to Michigan State, a place where they haven't won since 1995. Kirk Ferentz has never won there. The Hawks, as I mentioned, come in at 7-0, 3-0 in the Big Ten last week, winning at Wisconsin 20-10. This week, it's all about defense. It's going to be Iowa's nation-leading 15-interception defense, led by Pat Anger, Amari Spivey, and Adrian Claiborne going up against Kirk Cousins and the Michigan State offense. On the other side of the ball, we have Ricky Stanzi, who last week had a good game against Wisconsin, mistake-free, threw his touchdown to Tony Moiaki, going up against Greg Jones, Big Ten's leading tackler, and the Michigan State defense. Now, as I mentioned before, Kirk Cousins, the quarterback for Michigan State, is under kind of a hot streak right now. He's currently the leading passer in the Big Ten. Off to a nice start in the last three games. They're 3-0 in their last three after starting 1-3. Currently are in position to challenge the Hawkeyes for the Big Ten title should they win this game. Now, saying that, as I mentioned, they started off pretty bad at a 1-3 start. Last week, they beat a very mediocre Northwestern team. Before that, they beat Michigan, which was very untested in its first road game. Took them all the way into overtime for them to beat them. Now, I'm not saying that Michigan State is not a threat to the Hawkeyes because they are. Last year, game ended 16-13 in a defensive battle with Sean Green getting stopped on a 4th-and-1 in the final minutes of the game. So unfortunately, that was one of the key losses from last year. Now, having said that, the Hawkeyes are on an 11-game winning streak, which is second only to Florida. Keep that in mind. The number one team in the land, Florida, is the only team that has a longer winning streak than our Iowa Hawkeyes. Now, as I mentioned, Iowa's offense going up against Michigan State's defense. Now, the key to this is going to be our offensive line. If the offensive line keeps improving each week, as it did in the second half against Wisconsin last week, I think that it's going to be a big day for Ricky Stanzi. Yes, I know he's had his interception troubles. He's had 8 interceptions, 3 of which have been returned for touchdowns. Now, having said that, last game he was very good, no interceptions, over 200 yards passing, very efficient, was 17-23, and threw a key touchdown to Tony Moiaki in the second half. Now, which brings me to Tony Moiaki. The guy has been clutch. Since he came back in the Michigan game, he has caught 3 touchdowns and is now Iowa's leading touchdown receiver with 4 on the year. Now, if he can stay healthy, I believe that he will help Ricky Stanzi stay off of his interceptions and keep the offense plugging along with our two freshman running backs, Adam Robinson and Brandon Weger. Now, as I mentioned, if the offensive line plays well, that also means that Adam Robinson and Weger will have a good day. Not great, because Michigan State has a good defense. As I mentioned, Greg Jones, the middle linebacker, is an All-American type player. But if our offensive line shows up in the game, hopefully the entire game, not just the second half, like they did against Wisconsin, then we should be in pretty good shape. Now, Iowa's secondary had a great game against Wisconsin. Amari Spivey picking off 2, as well as A.J. Eades picking off 1, all coming in the second half. Now, I believe that with Kirk Cousins, Michigan State's quarterback, being banged up, as well as the backup nickels, both of which are hurting, I believe that Iowa's pass rush combined with our ball hawking secondary is going to create, I'm going to go with predicting 4 turnovers against Michigan State, three of which coming by interceptions. Now, who's going to make those interceptions? That all depends. It could be Spivey. It could be Tyler Sash, who is a beast. It could be Brett Greenwood or any of our three great linebackers. But that's just our defense. You don't know where it's going to come from. Now, Michigan State's defense, as I mentioned, is having a good couple games. It really has been kind of an up and down season for them. You're not sure which type of Michigan State team you're going to get. Now, the game is at night. Hawks are 2-0 in night games against Penn State as well as Michigan, both of which were close games. Penn State game, they started to pull away. Michigan, as we all know, it came down to about the last play or two. But at this point, they have been very untested. Michigan State has. This is their first game at night. As I mentioned at the beginning of this, Kirk Ferentz has not won a game at Spartan Stadium in his career. This is one of the main issues that people will have in predicting this game. For me, having won at Wisconsin and at Penn State in primetime games, I don't think that's going to affect the Hawkeyes whatsoever. They're used to it. That comes with a veteran ball club that gets better each week, which the Hawkeyes have been known to do under Kirk Ferentz, looking at last year as well as the 2004 season when they had bad starts, but got off and then eventually made some very good wins, including, of course, everyone remembers last year's monumental win at home against Penn State. Now, my prediction for this game is going to be Iowa 23, Michigan State 17. It's going to be a nail-biter, but I think Iowa's defense stays consistent. Our special teams also help us out in this with kick coverage as well as Daniel Murray kicking the field goals. As long as our defense does not allow a big play, and as long as Ricky Stanzi can avoid interceptions and turnovers, I think this is going to be a great win for the Hawkeyes. We're going to be 8-0 for the first time in history. Not even the 85 team that went to the Rose Bowl can say that. Not even the 85 team can say that. Think about that for a moment. Chuck Long, Ronnie Hartman can't say that they went 8-0. We might be able to, and on our way to a possible BCS bowl game. I don't want to count our chickens before they're hatched, but it's just something to think about. Like I said, this is my first blog. It might be a little bit rough, but I'm glad I could share my thoughts. I'll be posting a new one, typically on the day after the game is, with my thoughts, and then with predictions for next week's game. All right, this is Dave signing off.